Hi everybody, it's Joan from Laws of Knitting. Today I'm going to show you how to add a new skein or a new color to your knitting. This is actually a video from my sister Anne Marie. Shout out to my sister Anne Marie. She is learning to knit, or she's learned to knit, and she's made a zillion dishcloths, but they're all solid colors. And I told her to go ahead and just use all her scrap yarn and use it up and make striped dishcloths. And she couldn't get that wrapped around her brain, and I just couldn't seem to talk her through it over the phone. So I'm making this video for my sister, and maybe somebody else will get some use out of it. So I'm just kind of winging it. It may not be super professional. I'm just trying to get this video up so my sister can watch it and start knitting her dishcloths. Okay. So this is what we did, or I did. I worked up these three dishcloths. So I now have three skeins of leftover yarn from those three dishcloths, okay? So what I want to do, I do it all the time, is I use it up and just make striped dishcloths. Okay, now Anne, don't let this freak you out that I'm using double pointed needles. I have done that. If I'm making something small, I'll just put a point protector on one of the ends and use it as a straight needle. And the reason I'm using this today is because I started a video using my long straight needles, but when I was knitting, they just kept banging on the table and the sound was just very irritating. So I switched to the double points because it is smaller. And the reason I didn't use my circular needles is because I want this knitting to lay flat so you can see it easier in the video. So don't freak out that I'm using these small double points. That's the only reason I'm using them. So get past that. Okay, so now I worked up a little bit of this dishcloth I'm going to knit. And I don't want to use my red yarn anymore. I want to switch to one of these other ones. So let's just grab the yellow because it's easy to see, and you'll see what I mean. Okay, so this yarn this red yarn is now my old yarn because I'm not going to use it anymore. Now I want to use the yellow. So this is my new yarn, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my new yarn and I'm going to make a slip knot on my old yarn. Just like that. Okay, see that? Now, just grab your old yarn like that and slide that slip knot right down, okay? Now you could start another skein in the middle, but that's a whole nother video because you have to, when you're weaving in your ends, you have to twist them around each other so there's no knot. So don't worry about that. Just start your new yarn on the end, okay? And it's really best to do it on the right side row, because it transitions smoothly that way. So anyway, oh, so I need to cut your old yarn, and you know me, I give myself tons of yarn, so boom, I cut that. Now weave this in later. Okay, so now the yellow yarn is my new yarn. So I'm just gonna go ahead and knit with it, just like that. That's all you do, is just start knitting with it. And some people, actually a lot of people, they don't tie a slip knot onto the old yarn. They just cut the old yarn, leaving themselves a pretty good sized tail to weave in. And then they just pick up the new yarn and start knitting with it. They don't tie a knot or anything. And that works just fine. But I'm showing you this because this is how I do it. And that's all that is to it. See, I'm just starting a new color. And then just knit as many rows as you want with this. And then when you want to use your third scrap yarn, just do the same thing. At the beginning of a row, preferably the right side row, but it doesn't really matter. You know, a dishcloth's a dishcloth. And then just tie a slip knot on to the old yarn and start knitting with the new. So you'll have a three-striped dishcloth. There you go. Okay, give me a call if you have any other questions, or if anybody's watching this that is not my sister and doesn't know my phone number, just leave a message or Facebook me or whatever. And if you like this, please click the like button, and I would love to have you click the subscribe button. And below the video is are all the links to my Facebook, Google, Etsy, Pinterest, Ravelry, all that stuff, if you want to stay in contact with me. Okay, have a great day, and I hope this helped, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.